हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज अ मिसेलेनियस लेक्चर ऑन इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैड अ डिस्कशन ऑन द टॉपिक्स लाइक द बेसिक्स ऑफ चार्जेस एंड फोर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ चार्जेस, दैट इज क्वांटाइजेशन, कंजर्वेशन, एडिटिविटी एंड प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स। देन वी हैड अ डिस्कशन ऑन इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल एंड पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस एंड वी कंक्लूडेड दैट potential difference is very much required to maintain the flow of current between two points. Then we had a discussion on resistance also a little bit, and in this lecture I called it as a miscellaneous lecture because we are going to discuss the establishment of all these three four basic parameters with the help of simulation. We'll be able to see and justify how the variation in one parameters affects the other parameters. So if we see the learning objective and learning outcomes of this lesson, this particular lecture, the objective is to explain the basic relations between the very important parameters of electricity, that is voltage, current and resistance, through practical simulation. And after studying this lecture, after going through this content, the learners will be able to understand and justify the relation between voltage, current and resistance. So without wasting much time, let us start with the simulation, because theory we have already studied in my previous lectures. So let us start with the simulation part. Now this is a very basic simulation which we have taken to study the relation between voltage, current, resistance, and always the flow of current produces the heating effect around a current carrying conductor, in the current carrying conductor. So we have taken this battery which has maintained the potential difference. These are the two ends of the battery, and this is the piece of conductor what we have taken for our analysis. These blue dots are considered as a free electrons here, and this is a connection which is connected to the ammeter which reads current in amperes. This is just a scale to indicate the hotness or coldness of the conductor due to the flow of current. Here we have different parameters like show course, show voltage calculation, show inside battery or how the electrons are flowing. Then this is the resistance, and in the simulation we have a facility to vary this resistance and see how the current is changing. Here we have voltage value also. As per our requirement, we can see how with the variation of voltage the current is changing. So without wasting much time, let us start with the simulation. As soon as we have played the simulation, these free electrons are randomly moving. There is no potential difference applied across these two ends of the conductor. This is the first end we may consider, and this is the second end, and these are the terminals of the battery. And here we can see that this is a 0.00 volt. The hotness, if we talk about, or the coldness, if we talk about, this pointer is indicating at the cold side when there is no flow of current. Now, if we increase the value of voltage a little bit, then you may observe that the current will start flowing. So this is how the current starts flowing. The potential difference between the two ends of the conductor, this is the two ends of the conductor, it is almost 1 volt. You may say this is 0.96 volt it is showing. Now if I keep this voltage at the extreme position, extremely high, then you may observe that the electrons have started flowing very heavily, very rapidly from one end to the other end, which indicates the very high flow of current across the ends of the conductor. And if you have observed this, this pointer has also moved from cold to hot. That means the current, if the current increases, then the heating effect of current is also produced. The heat is also produced in the conductor due to the flow of current. Now if I increase, so from this simulation we have cleared that with increase in voltage the current will definitely increase. Now the potential is around 11.76 volt. Now if I increase the resistance, then what will happen? as we know that with increase in resistance, the current decreases, and we are able to see the velocity of the electron has reduced, which indicates there is a less flow of current across the ends of the conductor. And if you observe this cooling scale also, it is slowly moving towards the cooler end, which indicates with a decrease in current, the heating effect of current also decreases. This we will discuss little later also in Joule's law of heating. We will discuss the heating effect of current, which indicates whenever a current flows through the conductor, then the heat is produced inside the conductor, and that is called heating effect of current. So we have seen this key with increase in voltage. If I take this voltage at the negative side, then you will observe that the direction of current is reversed. You can see these cores. I'm just going to click this value. So inside the battery also you'll be able to observe the flow of electron. So when I have kept the voltage at the extreme negative value, the direction of current has reversed. When I am taking it to zero, again the current will reduce. And again I am taking it to positive values, with the increase in voltage the current will also increase. This is the first conclusion that we may draw from here. Given with increase in voltage, the current will also increase. And if I have taken this voltage to the extreme value with the high resistance, if I am going to reduce this resistance, again the current is going to increase. So we have seen the relation between voltage and current. With increase in voltage, current is increasing. We have seen the relation between resistance and current. With increase in resistance, the current is decreasing. We have seen the relation between heating effect of current, that is heat produced, and current. With increase in current, the heating is also increased. So this is the three points, basic points that we may conclude from this simulation. And we have practically verified that whatever we have studied in theory, it is very much verified here in practical simulation also. In my next lectures, we will have a discussion on resistance and resistivity. Thank you so much.